everyone. This is Phil Hickey. I'm going to teach you how to make an underwater hockey glove. Today we'll be doing step one, the finished product of which is this. It's just a very thin layer. It's just the base coat. We're not going to add any padding yet. We're going to fold the cuff down to make a nice snug cuff at the wrist. And we're going to smear silicone into the fabric of the glove everywhere. This increases the longevity of the glove and helps the padding layer stick better. So that's what we're shooting for right there. The supplies you'll want: caulk gun, 100% silicone caulk. I use white, and I also use silicone 1 by GE. Do not use silicone 2 by GE. It will take a long, long time to dry. You'll also want a small bucket for mixing the caulk, water-based poster paint, a knife to cut the end off the caulk, piece of wire or a stick to puncture the foil seal in the caulk, a stick for mixing. I don't use popsicle sticks, they're a bit flimsy. I actually use sticks that I cut in the shop made out of maple. They're quite a bit sturdier than popsicle sticks. Another small bucket for trash, a poly food service glove. This is very thin material. This is what the packaging looks like for those. A vinyl or latex glove for your freehand. This is what the packaging looks like for those. It's useful to have an underwater hockey stick to hold in your hand so you get the shape of the glove right while it's drying. And I also find it useful to have a clamp so I can clamp my mixing bucket to something sturdy so while I'm scooping caulk out of it, it doesn't flop around. Okay, that's it for supplies. Let's get going. For my caulk gun, I use 4 squirts of caulk for this step. You might want to go 5. Caulking guns probably vary a little bit from gun to gun, and it's better to have too much than to run out. I add poster paint in a ratio of about 1 small drop for every 2 squirts from the caulking gun. So 4 squirts of caulk, I'm going to add 2 drops of paint. We're talking very small drops here, the smallest amount you can squeeze out and let fall into the caulk. That's it. Now we're going to mix this up. You want to get a good, thorough mix. No bits of caulk that don't have paint in them, no big dollops of paint that aren't blended in. And since I'm using white caulk, I get kind of a pastel, pale, very pale green color here. For the base coat, I like neutral colors like that. For the padding coat, we'll do more vibrant colors, which will be accomplished by using clear caulk instead of white. So that's what we're looking at. You can probably hardly even see the color. It probably just looks white, but it will dry much more quickly than had I not added the paint. So we're going to clean off the edges of the mixing stick here. I'm going to set that down. I'm going to be making a glove on my right hand. One moment. Here's the last item we need, obviously the glove itself. This is a string knit glove, size small. I sometimes use medium for my hands, I sometimes use small. What you want to avoid is a glove that doesn't come all the way down onto your fingers. If the crotches of the glove aren't all the way into the crotches of your fingers, that's bad. So we're going to do a small today. Start with the poly food service glove on your playing hand. These can be a little tricky to get on, especially if it's moist in the air or your hand is sweaty. Try to work it onto your fingers without tearing a hole in the glove. The material of these gloves is a bit flimsy. You can tear a hole in them if you're not careful. I sometimes use a little bit of baby powder on my hands before I put this on. Today I managed to do without. And this is going to bunch up a little bit around your fingers. That's okay. the fabric is so, the material of the glove is so thin that a little bit of bunching doesn't create much trouble. Then we're going to put on the string knit glove, snug it on everywhere. You're always pulling it down onto your hand. And then we're going to put the vinyl or latex glove on our free hand. We'll use that for smearing the caulk in. Okay, ready to go. At this point, I would normally clamp the bucket of caulk onto a solid structure, but I don't have one handy, so we're going to do without. Good idea to kind of clear your workspace. And now we're going to start. I'm actually going to move closer to the camera so you can see this in a little more detail. We're going to start by getting some caulk on the stick, and we're going to smear it into the cuff area of the glove. The idea here is to get it into the fabric and also have just a little bit built up on the surface. This is going to be for the purpose of sticking the cuff to itself when we fold it over to create a padded cuff. And you don't have to be super careful about the application. I'm just trying not to get too much of it on my skin. So I go right up to the cuff of the glove and then stop. And you can go pretty far up onto the glove this way. Obviously, I'm not going all the way to the knuckles. We'll be doing that in a minute. But you want to get enough that when you fold it over, you have caulk in between the layers all the way up. So we're going to keep adding around the cuff until we've got it smeared in everywhere. I'm not pressing super hard here. You don't need it to be all the way through to the other side of the fabric. You just want a decent level of caulk in the mesh of the fabric. And a little bit built up on the surface, not too much. The reason for building some up on the surface here is that it gives just a little bit of padding in the cuff area, which is nice for when you get hit on the wrist with a puck. A little bit of padding there goes a long way. So we've used maybe a third of the caulk we mixed up for the cuff area here. I'm just going to go around, smooth out any lumps, make sure I've got everything, no dry spots. I'm going to put my stick down, and using my gloved hand, I'm just going to fold the cuff over on itself to a distance of about 3/4 of an inch. And you try not to get it bunched up, try to get a nice flat fold over. You can actually get rid of bunches in the fabric just by kind of pressing on them. The silicone underneath will lubricate and it'll slide around on itself. And you can adjust the level of fold by pulling back on the end or pulling up on the end of the cuff. You don't want to squeeze and press too hard here. You want to leave a little bit of the padding caulk in between the layers of fabric that we talked about for cushioning. Just make sure you got a good stick everywhere around. You don't have to put more silicone on the outside of the double layer. You can if you want. I might do that at the end if I have some left over. But now we're going to move on to the step of smearing caulk into the fabric all over. I don't usually use a stick for this, I just use my fingers. I'm just going to scoop it out of the bucket onto my fingers like that. And then using my fingers of my free hand, I'm going to start working it into the fabric. And you'll notice I'm always pulling from the tips of my fingers down towards my hand. And the reason for that is you want to keep the fingers stretched out as long as they can possibly get. So the crotches of the glove are all the way down into the crotches of your finger. That dramatically improves the dexterity that you'll have once the glove is finished. If you don't do that, you'll end up with a glove that's more like a mitten where all the fingers kind of have to work together. So I'm always pulling down, always pulling down. And I'm just trying to smear the caulk into all the pores of the fabric. You don't want any fabric that's dry. Now here, when you're on the back near the cuff, it's going to be easy to unroll the cuff if you're not careful. So I kind of work carefully one finger at a time. You can go sideways. You can actually go backwards down towards the fingers a little bit. You'll get some bunch up. You want to pull those bunches back out afterwards. And obviously here, practice makes perfect. I've done a lot of these. But you'll get the hang of it if you do a few. We're just continuing to get little daubs of silicone on her fingers. I kind of use the fingers of this hand like a scoop. I put them all together and I pull with all the fingers together. Creates a nice uniform layer, doesn't leave any big dollops. You can actually use the tips of your fingers kind of like a squeegee. If you have some caulk built up that you want to smear flat or feather out, you kind of press and pull at the same time. Silicone is an odd material. It takes some practice to get the hang of what you can and can't do with it. But it does smear and smooth quite nicely. So I'm working my way around the thumb. Now, there's a little bit of room for personal preference here. I like to get my thumb completely coated. Some people like to leave a bare patch on the front of the thumb to increase the feel of the stick in your hand. I find that the thumb wears out on my glove very quickly if I don't put silicone all the way around it, and I don't really mind having a thin layer of silicone between the ball of my thumb and the back of my stick. If you do mind that, you might want to leave that place bare. Continuing to work, I do the side of my index finger along here, but I try to leave a little bit bare on the front of each finger in this region, and then I'll also leave a pretty good chunk in the palm bare. So this area here, and then out onto each finger, there'll be a bare section of fabric when I'm finished. You don't have to do that, but it will improve the feel of the stick in your hand. And I find that it takes those areas a pretty long time to wear out. So even without silicone on there, my glove has pretty good longevity. I usually do try to get a good layer along the heel side of my hand. That is a point that does wear out on my gloves. So I try to get that pretty well smeared. And now I'm going to do on the top knuckle, the tip knuckle of each finger, I'm going to put some on the front side of the glove, because those are very high wear out points. But I try to just get the last knuckle. Don't come down too far onto the middle part of my finger there. There's always a trade-off between the glove's longevity and the amount of feel you get on the stick and the amount of dexterity your hand is going to have. Obviously, the more silicone you put on it, the better it'll last and the worse it will perform, generally speaking. So I try to find a happy medium. And of course, experience is the best teacher in that regard. Once you've made 20 gloves and used each one of them until it's worn out, you kind of know what level of compromise you're shooting for there. So I'm going back over some of the areas I did early on. Just any place I've seen some gaps in the fabric open up, get a little more caulk into them. Always smearing flat and trying to avoid buildup. It's okay if you get a little extra on the backs of the fingers where you're going to be adding padding later anyway. You want to avoid having any buildup between the fingers. That's an area that you want. You want the fingers to be able to get as close to each other as possible so you get a very natural feel when you're holding things in your hand with the glove on. So anytime you notice any buildup between the fingers, use a clean finger of your other hand to just kind of squeegee it out. Try to drag the silicone, smear it flat, smooth, drag any extra out of the way. Okay, I'm going to come close to the camera so you can see this now. Got rid of almost all the voids in the fabric. You can see there's a few voids here. Any place where your hand tends to stretch and relax, you're probably going to open some voids. Down here on the base of the thumb, there's a few. It's okay to have a few of those in places where you've got some big stretch zones in your hand, but if you have caulk left over and you've got some time, just go back and one by one add a little more caulk to those places and really press it in. And that'll go a long way towards improving longevity. By this point, the sticking on the cuff that I did is pretty much dry, so I don't have to worry too much about unrolling the cuff anymore, so I can be a little more aggressive dabbing into spots around the cuff area. If you decide you want to alter the level of fold at this point, it'll be a little harder to do. I'm actually accomplishing that a little bit right now just by tugging pretty hard at the back of the cuff. I'm unrolling it a little bit effectively because I want it to be just a little further down onto my wrist. Okay. Just get a few last places here where I've got some voids in the fabric. Pay a lot of attention to the fingertips. It's really easy to miss places around the tips of your fingers. You've got to look at them from all angles. It's good if you've got good light where you're working so you can see everything well. Okay, and then if you have any caulk left over, as I mentioned earlier, you can add a little onto the outside of the double layer cuff. Don't usually have much trouble with the cuff of my glove wearing out, but obviously the silicone is going to add a little protection there, so if you play on a rough bottom, it doesn't hurt to give it just a little bit of silicone on the outside of the double layer. Down to just about the end of our caulk, which is about right. If you've got some left over at this point, it's okay to leave it in the bucket. You can peel it out after it's dry. It comes out in kind of a rubbery filament. You feel like you're making special effects for a movie when you do that, because it's kind of cool, goopy, grippy, rubbery stuff. Just noticed one last little void on the heel side of my hand here. Pack that in. Okay, so this is what you should have. Smeared in everywhere, blank on the palm if you want it. Pulled down into all the crotches of your fingers everywhere, and a nice folded over cuff at the wrist. At this point, I'm going to remove the glove off this hand. If you've got a helper to pull it off, it's good. Otherwise, you can use your teeth. Au gras. Throw that away. Now you can either just fold the glove into a stick holding position. It's okay if the fingers stick together and it's okay if the fingertips stick to the palm. Or you can put a stick in your hand to achieve the correct position. What you want to avoid here is getting any bunches in the palm of the glove. So what I do is I lay the stick in it like that with the palm flat, and then I carefully roll my fingers around the stick. And you can feel if there's any places where the fabric is bunched up between your hand and the stick. You want to unroll your hand and do that again. You want to get it to where there's a nice single layer of fabric everywhere. Those bunched up areas really affect the feel of the stick in your hand. So at that point, you're finished all the work. You just need to sit and wait for it to dry. If you mix the same ratio of paint to caulk that I did, it should take 15 minutes tops. If you use less paint, it might take a little longer. If you use no paint at all, it might take as much as half an hour or 45 minutes. And I'm going to add just a little caulk here to a place on my thumb that I noticed. It's inevitable that as soon as you take the glove off your left hand, you're going to find some places that need more. And if you've got a towel or a rag nearby to wipe off your hand, that helps. Or if you don't care about the trousers you're wearing, you can wipe it on those. And a little bit of silicone on your hands doesn't do too much harm. It peels off pretty well once it's dry, or you can wipe it off while it's still wet. It's a bit of a pain if you get it under your fingernails. It takes a long time to get out. Okay, so we're finished. I'm just going to sit with this on here for about 15 minutes, and then I'll come back and show you the next step.